Saving up for a down payment can feel like an impossible feat. So if you're a first-time homebuyer in Canada, you'll be happy to know that you may be able to withdraw up to $25,000 from your RRSP tax-free. We've brought in Toronto realtor Lauren Haw to walk you through the details of the RRSP Home Buyers Plan.
In order to be eligible for the RRSP Home Buyers Plan, there are a few requirements that you need to meet. First, you cannot have owned a home in the last 4 years. Next, you must sign an agreement to buy the home, and you must intend to live in the property within a year. If you've used the home buyer's plan in the past, you cannot have an outstanding balance. You must make the withdrawal within 30 days of taking title of the home. And finally, money has to be in the RRSP account for a minimum of 90 days prior to withdrawal. If you satisfy all of the requirements, you can withdraw up to $25,000 towards your down payment. If you're buying a home with your partner and you both meet the requirements, you can each withdraw up to $25,000 towards your down payment for a total of $50,000. If you're buying a home with your partner and only one of you meets the requirements, that eligible partner can still withdraw up to $25,000 from their RRSP. Think about this one-time tax-free withdrawal as a loan from your RRSP to yourself. The CRA requires that that loan is repaid within a 15-year period. Let's take a look at how the RRSP Home Buyer Plan works. The government requires that you make the first repayment 2 years following your home purchase. So in this example, our home buyer purchases the home in 2013 and withdraws $19,500 from their RRSP account. That means in the year 2015, they have to make their first payment. Let's figure out how much that payment is. We take the total amount of the withdrawal, $19,500, divided by 15 years, and we come up with the minimum payment. This minimum $1,300 payment has to be made each and every year. You might be wondering what happens if that $1,300 payment is not made. In any year where you fail to make the minimum payment, you have to claim the difference as taxable income on your annual return. Going back to our original example, our minimum payment was $1,300. So in a year that you only make a payment of $1,000, we calculate the difference to be $300, and that $300 difference has to be claimed as taxable income on your annual return. Let's take a look at what happens when we make a payment larger than the minimum. In the year 2013, we purchase a home and withdraw $19,500 from our RRSP. In the year 2015, you made your first minimum payment of $1,300. In the year 2016, we make a large payment of $8,075. That means 2017 going forward, we need to calculate a new minimum. We do that by taking the original withdrawal amount, subtract the total paid so far, and that will bring us to $10,125. We divide that new balance by the 13 years remaining to bring us to a new minimum payment of $778.85.